how to launch your first Facebook ad campaign on today's episode.
Today's episode is brought to you by AWeber. Email is perfect for connecting your brand to your audience. Whether they make a purchase, read your blog, or meet you in person, email automation begins where the conversation left off. To see how AWeber can help your business and get your first month free, go to servenomaster.com/AWeber.
Are you tired of dealing with your boss? Do you feel underpaid and underappreciated? If you want to make it online, fire your boss, and start living your retirement dreams now, then you've come to the right place. Welcome to Serve No Master Podcast, where you'll learn how to open new revenue streams and make money while you sleep. Presented live from a tropical island in the South Pacific by best-selling author Jonathan Green. Now, here's your host.
I've wanted to get into Facebook ads for years and years now, and I've always found it so daunting. I would rather spend $300 paying someone to do some SEO or some offsite traffic stuff than I would spend $10 on paid advertisement for Facebook. I've always found it very daunting, and it's very, very complicated on a mechanical level, setting up your first ad. I spent all of yesterday working on my first ad campaign, and that's why I want to share with you today what I've learned and what I'm putting together, so that you can replicate the process and see that it doesn't have to be that overwhelming. Once you understand the structure of your campaign, then it's about building each piece and understanding the core components. And the structure is where I always felt really confused because I got a lot of conflicting information, but now I'm really dialed in and I want to take you through exactly what I'm doing and exactly what you can do to launch a campaign and just spend $5 or $10 a day until you get it profitable. You don't have to spend hundreds of dollars a day. A lot of people tell you that, it's not true. So let me walk you through each step. The first thing is deciding what you want to sell or what your end goal is. So we start with the goal in mind. Now, I have two goals with my ad campaigns on Facebook. I want to bring people into my funnel, which means I want them to join my mailing list, become aware of me, and allow me to communicate with them. Then I want people to purchase something. Those are the two things I want. So my two goals are a lead, which means I have the email address, and a conversion, which is a purchase. Those are the two metrics I'm measuring. And I'll measure both of them to see the real value and to get really tight statistics. That's what I'm really, really focused on. And the more you know what you want, the easier it is to do. So then you have to think on exactly what you want to sell. So your first product, your $7 or $17 product, your tripwire product, that's what you're going to sell. And rather than just walk you through exactly what I'm doing, I want to explain the psychology of each piece. So the first thing we have is the Facebook ad. And the Facebook ad has to offer to teach something or share something valuable. So your first Facebook ad could be, let me show you five key stretches you have to do before any yoga exercise or you'll get injured. Very simple. And yes, we're using the yoga example because you know I love it. What this allows you to do is teach something very, very simple. Then in your second step, once people see what you're offering, they give you their email address. So you send them from your advertisement to a page on your website that's a lead capture page that says, hey, let me show you how to do these five key stretches. I put together a little 5 or 6 minute video. Just enter your email address below and I'll show you the video. And then the next page, you show them that video and then you say, here's the stretches. Now, if you want to do an entire workout that only lasts 20 minutes and makes your body super resilient, buy this offer. So you go advertisement, opt-in page, delivery page, and then sales page. Now, sometimes you kind of merge the delivery and sales page, but you're taking people through a flow and it has to be very, very logical. It has to make sense. So whatever you're teaching has to make sense along the path to what you want people to do or what you want people to buy. Now, when people make a purchase, they become a member of your tribe. So the sooner you can get them to that purchase, the better. But you want to take them through a very logical flow. Another example is to walk people all the way up to the door to the solution. And then you say, for the final step, here's what you do. When you have these pieces in place, you then can start to run a campaign. It doesn't have to be very complicated. And we could talk about targeting and other stuff down the line. I just want to help you design your first funnel today. Something very simple and very easy to do and not overly complicated. So we have our ad, and the purpose of your ad is to get people to go visit your landing page. And the purpose of your landing page is to get people to opt in. So ad can say something like, find out the five stretches you have to do before yoga, or, hey, does your back hurt from yoga, or did you hurt your knee before you went to yoga class? anything like that, right? We can go negative or positive. Do you want to prevent injury or do you want to recover from injury? Then your page says, let me teach you these five key exercises. Just enter your name below. That page is your squeeze page, your opt-in page. That page is critical. So these first two pages are really what will control how many people click on your ad and how many people give their email addresses. So those are your first two conversion pieces. And they should really fit together well as far as design, as far as imagery, and those pieces. Now, your first ad, you're probably going to feel like, oh, how can I design the perfect ad? It's not going to be perfect. And I feel the exact same way. I've started using a new tool called Ad Espresso. It's $50 a month, $49 a month. It's not too expensive. And what it allows you to do is create multiple versions. So it says upload another picture that you want to use. And so you upload five or six different pictures and it will test to see which picture works the best. And it will say, this is the best picture for getting email addresses. And this is the picture that generated the most money. And that type of testing is where we'll find our success. It's very important to be able to split test. And split testing just means you try two different versions and see which one does better. And what we want to have is different headlines, different descriptions, different links, all those different pieces. And we really, really want to test those. And once you get that ad perfect, you then want to begin tweaking and messing around with the landing page, which you can test later on, make a couple of different versions. And again, this doesn't have to be overwhelming. This has to be really, really simple. For me to do it, it has to be simple. I don't want to spend like 6 hours designing every different ad and feeling overwhelmed all the time. What you want is something that's simple to do. So you upload a couple of images and it really walks you through how to put together your images. That's why I finally feel comfortable really doing this. Once you send people to that landing page, once you have that email address, you have a relationship. The relationship allows you to email them over and over again. Whenever I get someone's email address, whenever someone joins my email list, I feel like they're a provisional tribal member. They're a provisional member of the servenomaster tribe. And when they've done this, what I want to do is introduce them to everything. I want to show them podcast episodes. I want to show them blog episodes. I want to show them a lot of content, a lot of value. I don't need every single person that visits servenomaster to become a customer. That's okay if they don't. It's okay if you're visiting my website, if you're listening to this podcast and you never buy anything from me, that's fine. There's no obligation. A lot of the people who visit my website and listen to this podcast and never take action, they never purchase anything, they leave the most comments, they leave the most reviews, and they tell the most people about me. And all of those things are worth their weight in gold. I'm just as happy for you to click like on one of my Facebook posts because that will get the word out to someone who does want to be a customer, and that helps my business just as much. That's why I provide so much free content. That's why I work my tail off to record 5 podcast episodes a week. It's not that easy to crank out 5 of these every single week to find the time between when my kids aren't screaming and when there's no noise around the house. It's not that easy. Especially now it's the rainy season, which means it's always raining outside. So I have to record inside more and more. But you want to get that email address so you can form that relationship. Now, some people will run a Facebook campaign directly to a sales page, directly to an offer. That's not what we're doing here. That's not my particular business model, and that doesn't fully sync up with what we're teaching. Here's why. When you send people to your sales page, you have one chance to make the sale. And if it doesn't work, you don't have a second chance. So rather than allow that to happen to you, I want to focus on getting you a nice little mailing list. With a mailing list and the ability to reach people over and over and over again, and as you know, I use ConvertKit, and I'm a big fan of ConvertKit for sending out emails, you get a chance to really form a relationship. People reply to your messages, people will talk to you, and you can find out what they like, what they don't like. You can find out why people buy or don't buy your different offers. All of that stuff is gold. So take the time to design a very simple flow. So now what we have to build before we launch our ad, and I know it's a few pieces, we have to build our ad, we have to build the landing page where we take the email address, and then I want you to write 5 or 6 or 7 emails that introduce people to you, get them to know you, and then try to offer them something, whether you're offering to sell them your book on Amazon or something else. All of that's really valuable, and all of that's really valuable to you because you're forming a relationship, and you're also letting them know what you have for sale, because once they get to like you, people will buy from you. People buy from people they trust, and it's very important to build trust. There's a reason my real name, my real picture is all over my website. That real information helps to build trust. And oftentimes when someone buys the first thing from me, when they buy something for, you know, $7 or $10, whatever, what they're really doing is seeing if it's real. People want to see if after they give money, they get what they paid for. And some people will spend $10 and then they feel comfortable and then they'll buy something for $5,000. And that's what you're developing. Trust is that valuable. So you want to make that first sale, and that's called a tripwire sale. So that part of your funnel is the next page. You have the delivery page, which says, thank you so much for your email address. Here's the training I offered you. Or you could say, thank you so much. Your special gift is on its way to your email right now. But while you're waiting, please watch this awesome video. And it's a sales video. And we have that sales video there because you already have their attention. And what you've accomplished at this point is you've taken someone several steps up a yes ladder. First, they clicked your ad. Then they entered their email address and clicked send. So now they've taken two actions, each one a further escalation up a yes ladder. First, they've agreed to look at your sales page for your opt-in. Then they've agreed to the opt-in to give you their email address. Now you're just asking for them to give you an order. So it's an escalation. Now the purpose of having an offer here is to pay for the cost of your ads. Recently, my friend ran a campaign. He'd made a lot of mistakes and he was paying $6.50 for a click. That's insanity. That's not going to happen to you. You're probably going to spend around 20 to 30 cents per click. So let's say it costs us 20 cents per click. So 100 visitors is $20. Very simple. If we can get three out of those 100 people to spend $7 with us, our ad is profitable on the day of the ad. Now, most ads are not this successful. Most ads, to be successful on Facebook, they go through a sequence. I know someone who buys traffic and it takes him 71 days for each email address to become profitable, but it's okay because he knows it'll eventually happen, right? So he can spend $1,000 today and in 3 months, he'll have $1,100. Depending upon how much money you have to bridge the gap, this determines how much you can scale. So what we want to do is make back the cost of your ads as quickly as possible. So maybe you discover that you have a 1% conversion rate. For every $20 you spend, you make $7 back on the first day. But then through that series of email addresses, through that series of email sequence, you send the message after message, two more people buy later in the week. Now you can afford to scale. So now instead of spending $20, you spend $200. Instead of making $1, you make $10. Now obviously, we don't want to spend $1,000 to make $100, but I want to give you the idea, the principle, so you fully understand it. When we structure our Facebook ad, it's all about systems. It's all about thinking money in, money out. If you can spend a dollar, make a dollar 10, that's wonderful. That means you could spend $1 million and make $100,000 every single day. That's awesome. That's really the goal that you want to get to. So we want to design something that's very, very powerful. And the way to do that is by putting each thing in place scientifically. Now, after your sales page, the next thing you need to have is your upsell. This is where you offer them something else that's even more expensive. So if you're just starting out, you have your little yoga offer and you say, hey, here's 5 ways to prevent yoga injury. Number two, you offer them your $7 yoga bootcamp, your 20-minute workout video. And when they buy that, on the next page, it says, hey, let me give you a full 30-minute weight reversal, take control of your destiny training program, 30 days. So then you send them an entire program and it's $97. What this does is massively boost the value of each visitor. This might convert only 1 out of every 100 people who see it. So you have to sell 100 at $7 before one person buys this. But that boosts your sales numbers from $700 in profit to $800 in profit. And that's a big jump. That's like a 13% jump or something. That jump will really make a difference and will take an ad that was almost profitable and make it profitable. So we want to have these pieces in place. And by having these pieces in place, and let me walk you through them one more time. We have the ad, then we have the opt-in page, then we have the thank you page and the offer page. Now, sometimes we merge those two pages. The offer page is where we offer to sell them something, and then we have the upsell page. Then behind that, you can even have a second upsell if you want. No problem. A lot of my offers have two upsells. We want to put together this very simple process and it will allow you to really grow your business. I'm building this exact funnel right now and hopefully my ad will start running later today. And I'm going to begin testing and testing and testing because this is the big opportunity. Facebook is actually one of the easier networks to learn. AdEspresso makes it really easy to learn. They have some pretty good training. They have some really good software that makes it easy to design your ad. It's not scary anymore. Facebook has its own ad builder and that stuff's okay, but I've always found it daunting. So you don't have to use AdEspresso. I'm not an affiliate for AdEspresso. It's just what I happen to be using. I looked at some of the competition, and most of the competition, while really cool, is designed for more advanced people. And this is really like Quia, that's for advanced people, but AdEspresso is for beginners and it's really focused on beginners. And it gives you lots of stats and shows you what kind of people are buying and what kind of people are not. And as you run an ad, it will help you by saying, oh, this ad's doing better, this one's not. Better to target women than men. Make these changes. And it really tracks your targeting and will help you to improve your ad over time. So if you spend $5 or $10 a day, $100 to $50 to $300 a month, by the end of the month, you'll start to see a nice return on your investment. Don't be daunted by this sounding a little bit complicated. It should only take you 1 to 3 days to put together your first funnel, to build the pieces. The reason to me it's taken me more than 1 day to do everything is simply because I had to really design my structure. I had to put together the structure I just shared with you and say, this is what I want to do, and then start building the pages. And so right now, almost everything's built. The ad is done. The sales page and the upsell page are done. I just have to work on the other page. I just have to work on the landing page and connect it with ConvertKit. That's the last thing I'm doing today, and then I'll start running my ad. This is all you have to do to really create something cool. Put in a little bit of effort here and it will make some amazing things happen. Now, yesterday we talked a lot about book launches, but this episode is all about traffic. And as you know, traffic is worth 10 times more than content. If you can create a system, a funnel that generates money, you will actually be unstoppable. Way back in episode 3, when I interviewed Jim, that's how he went from struggling and staying at home every day to making millions. And now he lives full time, traveling the world and investing. Someone who's barely 30. Why? Because he mastered Facebook ads. More and more as we move into the next year, I'm going to be talking about buying traffic and different ways of doing it. I already buy traffic from some places. I've already done some dabbling with buying email traffic. I've done some traffic, a lot of buying of traffic for Amazon. I'm very comfortable buying traffic there. And now I'm moving into a new field. And I want to share with you my trepidation, the fact that I've been nervous about and hesitant about it. I've been watching Facebook courses for 3 months. And yesterday I was talking to someone and he was right. He goes, why are you hesitating? It's not even that much money. It's $5 or $10 a day. It's not a huge amount of money. Just do it. Stop being a coward. And he was right. I just got to pull the trigger. So I'm sharing that with you so you can see that even I, at my level, still feel that nervousness, sometimes still feel that trepidation. When it comes to designing your actual ads and everything else, I'll share more and more material with you down the line. For right now, it's just about beginning to build a structure. And the great thing about AdEspresso is it actually lets you see all the ads that are running. It tracks tons and tons of ads that are already on Facebook and shows you what they're doing and says, oh, here's a bunch of ads that are running. Now, it doesn't tell you which ones are winning and which ones aren't. There's other software that does that, but it shows you tons and tons of examples. And you look at them and go, this one works for me. I want to replicate this. This speaks to me. If you do that, you'll start to see some really cool success. And that's really, really exciting. I'm going to be doing a lot with Facebook ads this year. And the reason I'm recording this episode is to kind of lock myself in so that I have to do it. And by putting myself in a position where I have no choice, I actually recently have been struggling with, do I want to keep doing 5 podcast episodes a week? I've just crossed that 100 episode mark. And I realized I'm talking about doing something around 250, 260 episodes a year. That's a lot of episodes, but it also forces me to create lots and lots of content. And I think it's really valuable. So I'm kind of going through that decision-making process of, I'm now at 100. Should I just drop down to once a week and focus on some other stuff? So I am in a time of transition. I am thinking about a lot of these things. And I want to share with you exactly where I am so that you can give me honest feedback and you can kind of connect with me in a real way. And we can create something that's really, really amazing. The reason I don't want to slow down, you know, as much as I was like, oh, I'd love to have more time back so I could just do one episode a week. It's more of like, man, I have so much I want to share with you. I have so many ideas and so many episodes and so much content I want to give you that I'm nowhere close to out of ideas. It's just a matter of time balancing. And I really do love recording these podcast episodes for you. So what I want you to think about past that little digression is taking action. It's very easy to be overwhelmed by the idea of Facebook ads or something else, but it's not that complicated. And as long as you keep your spend low, your risk is very low. As long as you say, Facebook, I want my daily budget to be $5. Don't spend more than that. You have breathing room. Now, plenty of people say you have to have much larger spends and you have to spend a lot more money in those things. And maybe that's true, but I don't think so. I don't think you need to start out that big. I started that small with $3 and $5 spends to master Amazon ads, and now I'm moving into the next area. So you can start small to get a feel and see if something is totally failing or if something is totally succeeding, you'll see it early on and you can begin to tweak and slowly increase your spend. See, I don't want to spend $3,000 a month and watch it disappear on a failed campaign. But $300 a month, that's not that big of a deal. That's how I see money, right? Like, I think $3,000 is a lot of money. And as everyone else does, you should. So starting smaller and having room to test and get data and kind of tweak stuff, you can make a lot of things happen. And if you do decide to start running your ad campaign, and I really hope you do, if you start dabbling with Facebook ads or other type of paid advertising, please message me, podcast@servenomaster.com, and let's talk about it. I want to kind of share my experiences. And as I begin to run more campaigns, I'll share more and more of my experiences with you. But I want you to see where I'm at on day one, the day I'm going to start my Facebook campaigns, and I'll share more and more with you down the line so we can experience this journey together. But this is exactly how you design a successful Facebook advertising campaign.
Thank you for listening to this week's episode of Serve No Master. Make sure you subscribe so you never miss another episode. We'll be back tomorrow with more tips and tactics on how to escape that rat race. Head over to servenomaster.com/podcasts now for your chance to win a free copy of Jonathan's bestseller, Serve No Master. All you have to do is leave a 5-star review of this podcast. See you tomorrow.
Thank you for listening to the Serve No Master podcast. Email your questions to podcast@servenomaster.com, and your question with my answer might appear in the next episode.